Welcome to the Poor Man's Gourmet Kitchen, where we share gourmet recipes at a low-budget wonder. Now check this out. Here I've got just over a 3.5-pound beef tenderloin, and I picked this up for just under 20 bucks. And one of the first things you want to do is remove the silver skin, which runs down almost the entire length of the tenderloin. Slicing your knife along the edge of the silver skin is one of the most efficient and easiest ways to do it. Then you can lay your blade flat on one end, and by applying pressure, you can skim off the silver skin and work it off all the way to the end of the tenderloin. And by removing that, you won't get stuck with chewy beef sticks. But that's a lot of beef to let go to waste, so you want to take your knife down the whole length of that silver skin once again and remove that beef. It might seem a little tedious, and it might take a little finesse, but that's about another 2 beef sticks worth of beef right there. And now one full, cleaned beef tenderloin, ready for portioning for the meat grinder. Now, if you're not grinding your own meat, your butcher should be able to do this for you. Then you can just skip this step altogether. But it's important to know that the length of the grain here is going to affect how you grind your meat. Because this grain here is running lengthwise, and you're going to be sticking the meat down through the top of the grinder, it's going to wind horizontally, and then it's going to cut cross grain. That's going to make it a lot more tender bite when you bite into these beef sticks. So here we go, in through the top, out through the die, and into the mixing bowl. And once you go ahead and get that filled up all the way, you're going to go ahead and start adding your ingredients. I'm going to start with my homemade teriyaki sauce, followed by some salt, some coarse black pepper. I also like to squeeze in a little bit of hoisin sauce and a splash of sesame oil. And believe it or not, beef sticks are really good with pepper jack cheese. And you can spice it up with other ingredients if you prefer. I know mustard seed is one of the most popular ingredients in beef sticks. Diced jalapeno is really good too. The important thing here is to make sure all the ingredients are mixed thoroughly and that all that ground meat is seasoned evenly. At this point, I usually go ahead and cover it with some tin foil and throw it in the refrigerator and let it marinate for about 24 hours. Now in the past, I showed you how to use saran wrap to encase Italian sausage. We used natural hog casings for chorizo and homemade boudin. They're both easy and great ways to get her done. And I was able to do that by adding these simple horn attachments to my meat grinder. You have the large version, and you have a smaller version, which we would need to make these beef sticks. My problem is that the KitchenAid is too slow. And thanks to my patrons, I was able to save for several months to pick up this sausage stuffer, which holds 7 pounds of ground beef. It comes with several horn attachments as well, but this 16 millimeter is what we're going to go with to make these beef sticks. Now you should know I'm not getting paid for this. This is just a more efficient way to stuff sausage. And today we're going to be using these 17 millimeter collagen cases. They do not fit a 17 millimeter horn. That's why I'm using the 16. But they just unravel like a slinky, and they're easily applied to the attachment. And it allows me to put about 3.5 feet of casing on the horn. Personally, I wish it were more, but that's plenty. If you like this video, don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel. You'll reach a point where you can't get any more casing on there. And all you gotta do is just clip it with some scissors. Now take the marinated meat mix and stuff and fill the canister. It's important to get as much air out of there as possible, so just give it a quick press. Make sure everything's snug and tight in there. Then it easily hinges and slides right into place. Then just lower the press and you're ready to go. I like to twist the end of that collagen wrapper once the meat has reached the end of the horn. Then I can start stuffing the casings. And as you can see, it comes out pretty fast. And once you reach the end, you just do the same thing as the beginning and twist off that wrapper. And now we've got one lengthy beef stick. And there's several different ways you can do this. You can meet the two ends and fold it in half, and then twist the center so you've got two good portions. Or you can just leave it alone and cut it into pieces when it's all done. You can also use a tape measure from the end of the horn and adjust maybe your cutting board like I'm doing here to the length you want. This way every beef stick reaches the exact same length by stopping at the edge. Then twisting off the length at the end of the horn and then continuing on, repeating the same process. And once you're done, you should have something that looks like this. Along with the uneven portions. There'll even be a bit left over in the bottom of the canister that just doesn't quite get squeezed through the funnels. But this makes excellent teriyaki burger. Don't believe me? Look for yourself. Now I'm going to load these into my tiny little smoker. Now it's too cold outside right now for them to cook, but a couple hours of smoke will give it some great flavor. Just throw the door back on, and I've got a half pan of hickory chips. And after a couple hours of smoking, now I've got some flavor, but we're not done cooking yet. Probably would have been smart to measure the length of the depth of my smoker, because they're kinked. But because that smoke didn't cook them, they can still straighten out just fine. And we're just going to lay those down on an open rack in the oven. And just a tiny bit of space between each one. Even my odds and ends are going on the rack. And it's not a bad idea to have a cookie sheet catch the drippings. You want to cook at 220 degrees Fahrenheit for an hour and a half up to 2 hours. And when they're done, they should look something like this. Then using a pair of scissors, you can just snip between each piece, cut off all the odds and ends. But let's go ahead and bust one of these in half and look at the inside. Not too shabby. So you can see it's got some good buoyancy. Looks good to me. Now here I'm just going to put them in a container, but you don't really want to cover with a lid. You also don't want to ziplock them. It'll gain too much moisture. I'll talk more about the proper way to store them and their shelf life expectancy in the blog. And there you have it. Teriyaki beef sticks right here in the Poor Man's Gourmet Kitchen.
Thank you for watching, and be sure to stop by PoorMansGourmetKitchen.com for more recipes and exact ingredients.